Today I'll be showing you how to make a long labial bow. So we first take a 21 gauge wire. You can straighten the wire to reduce the stress, and then you have to adapt it to the labial portion of the incisors and the canines. So a long labial bow, it will run from your first premolar to the first premolar on the other side, or in extraction cases where the first premolars are extracted, it will run from second premolar to second premolar. Now that's how you adapt it. With hands only you can adapt the wire, curve it and adapt. And then you'll be doing the markings. Now for markings, after the adaptation, when it is adapted on the labial portion, you will mark the mesial surface of the premolar, first premolar in this case, on both the sides. And then midline also you will mark. Then from the premolar markings towards the gingiva, you will give a 90 degree bend. At this stage, the placement of the wire is little difficult. So arbitrarily, when you place the wire on the mesial surface of premolar, your U-loop, it should lie 1.5 to 2 mm below the marginal gingiva. So here you'll take the marking of that, the same, and same on the other side. Then with the help of universal plier only, at the marked portion, you will give a U or a round bend. You will have to do a slight changes over there. When you place this part, the first major thing you have to check is your midline should be coinciding with what you have marked on the wire, and on the other side you will have to give the same bend. And when this U will lie here, it should be 1.5 to 2 mm below the marginal gingiva. And for the crossover bend, you will have to take the marking. As the contact point between the premolars, it's not round, so you have to go for a 90 degree bend. And leaving the little bit, you can place it on the cast, taking the other marking on the palatal side. That's how you give the bend for retention. Cut the excess wire, which is not required. After placing this, you have to create tag arms, which will get embedded in the acrylic. It can be of any shape, basically. The purpose is that they should get nicely embedded in the acrylic. That's how it will look, 1.5 to 2 mm. It shouldn't impinge the gingiva. The crossover bends, they should lie just above the contact area, not over it. And the retention arm, that should adapt on the palate. And then, this is how the finished labial bow, long labial bow will look when you finish it on both the sides. It should lie on the middle third of the labial surface. U-loop should be perfect, 1.5 to 2 mm below marginal gingiva. The crossover arm and the palatal retentive arms for retention. Thank you.